So this next song, y'all don't know it's late, but I feel God in this room. God is here. This next song says the potter, right, wants to put me back together again. So we're going to sing a piece of this. I'm joined by one of South Africa's finest soloists. I hope I don't do too bad.
Give him
If you need it tonight, there is joy. For a minute.
Yeah. Give me love, give me love. 아, 우리 아쉬워,
아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아쉬워, 아
Look, guys, this is Usiko Kelewa Zokoza. A special greetings to my pastors at this moment and all the viewers at large. So during this COVID-19 epidemic, one of the things we did as a household is actually just focus more on eating healthier food to keep our immune systems in fighting shape. And for my personal devotions, YouTube and Facebook live sessions have been very helpful. And I took it upon myself with a couple of friends to actually just dive into the Word, taking it one chapter per day during this lockdown period. And yeah.
Hey, we are the Spielmans, and we'd like to share ukuthi ngelixesha thina sigcinekele kanjani ngelixesha le-lockdown.
Sigcine lelizwi and the devotions esizifumana through the links asenkonzweni. As umama umfundisi shared yesterday with devotion, that we were separated for a reason. So let us use this time to read the Word of God and pray. Stay home.
Stay safe.
Hello, Rap family, and to the viewers at large. We are the Ndamase family connecting with you from Kama Park, and we'd like to share with you how we're spending this time during lockdown.
Wow, the best of God in the worst of times. What a beautiful time we have as a family where we have devotions as a family. We study together, we support and help each other. What a beautiful time.
A beautiful time indeed. We've also started doing stuff as a family that we've never done before, like having evening workout sessions and Friday night movie night.
Yes, we also get to experience eCell, that is connect with our cell members via the internet.
What a beautiful time.
What a time to be alive.
God bless you.
God bless you.
We are the Sumpeta family.
Hello everybody, we have been reading the Word and doing devotions in the mornings. It helps the devotions that are done on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And moreover, when it comes to the brethren, we try by all means to do video calls where we can, to do phone calls where we can't video call, just to make sure that we are keeping in touch and checking up on the brethren.
So making use of the Bible app to have devotions together, and the plans that are there, we pick and choose a topic, and that's what we do together to stay in the Word and in prayer.
Yeah. Thank you.
Greetings, church, in the name of the Lord, our Jesus Christ. This is the Big Cable family.
COVID-19 has affected us in a bad and a good way. The bad way, we missed church activities and the fellowship with our Lord. Professionally, we have made some adjustments. The good way, we have more time to pray as a family. We have spent more time with each other, playing games and schoolwork. Most importantly, the live streaming sermons and morning devotions have kept us connected, and we are receiving the message of the Lord. We are staying positive and knowing that this is just a temporary thing. Things will get back to normal again.
Please be safe, stay home. God bless us all. Bye.
Bye.
Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. We as a family, we are using this lockdown period to meditate on the Word of God. Every Tuesday and Thursday, we are live streaming our morning devotions.
We as a family operating at 12 midday and at 12 midnight.
Every Sunday morning, we gather together in the lounge and we live stream the service, whether it be on YouTube or whether it be through Facebook. We come together and we intercede, we praise and we worship, and we enjoy our Sundays.
We experience the best of God in the worst of times.
Hello kids, and welcome once more to our Children's Church program. We're so excited to be with you this morning. We have a very exciting lineup for today. But first, do you know how you can keep safe and clean during this lockdown? No? Well, our friend Kungawo is going to show us how.
What's up guys, and I'm going to show you how you use hand sanitizer. Let's get started. One, two, three, and 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 one, two, three,
Wow, that was so cool, Kungawo. Thank you. Now we can all be safe and clean. Now that we are all nice and clean, let's get our Bibles and sit comfortably for today's word. Today we will read from Matthew chapter 7, verse 7 to 8. Let's read. Ask and you will receive. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you. Everyone who asks will receive. The one who searches will find. And the one who knocks, the door will be opened. How amazing is this? Jesus says you can ask for anything and you will receive. Well, today Jesus is inviting you, yes, you, to ask for whatever you want. Remember, God can do anything. He can do all things. He has unlimited treasure. He can even calm the storms. Can you believe it? Let's ask Him right now to protect us, our parents, and our city from all bad things. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you that we can ask for anything from you. Today, we just want to ask you to please protect us, our parents, and our dear city from all bad things. Amen. Wasn't that amazing? I think we should sing a song. Are you ready? Let's go.
From Matthew 7. We're going to start today with the verse.
I'm reading my B.I.B. early, and this is what it says to me. Tells me that I'm never ever alone. I'm learning how J.E.S.U.S. came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. Let's go! When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door.
Oh, oh. Great job, everyone. Now you know, ask, seek, knock.
Well, right, kids? We have come to the end of our program. We had so much fun together, didn't we? Remember to stay safe and clean. See you again next week for another cool session. Remember, you can ask your friends to join us for our sessions so we can have fun together. Well, bye!
Greetings once more in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We want to greet the Church of Jesus Christ, Rock Christian Church, Port Elizabeth. And we want to greet the entire Rock ministries at large in the nation. We want to greet the body of Christ. Every believer that has tuned in this morning and that has chosen to fellowship with us and go to church with us this morning. Well, it is yet another day, beautiful day, that the Lord has given us. And all we are going to do is to rejoice and be glad in this day. God has afforded us yet another opportunity for us to be in His presence, to pray together, and to glean on His word once more. And we are really looking forward to an amazing time that we are going to spend together. Of course, I am not alone as we're beginning the service. My wife, Pastor Chlubi, is here with us. And I'm going to ask her to lead us in prayer and just take us before the Lord as we begin this service together. Why don't you join together with us where you are? pray with us. Let's take this time to just pray and bring ourselves and bring this service and bring this meeting and, you know, open our hearts to the Lord and that the Lord would quicken our minds so that we would be in full understanding and comprehension of what He has in store for us today. Pastor Hlubi, please pray for us.
Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, this morning we welcome you, Spirit of the Living God. From our lips, we lift up our praise, O God. From our hearts, O Jesus, we lift up our adoration. We say you are holy, holy, holy are you, Lord, God Almighty. The whole earth is filled with your goodness. At this time, O God, we raise our voices, we raise our voices, we raise our souls to you, Lord God. And we say you are holy, you are beautiful, Lord Jesus. Father, because we are in you, we know, Lord Jesus, there's no sickness this morning that can saturate us. Because we are in you, oh God, we know there's no demon that can destroy us. We know, Lord Jesus, that there's no death that can overcome us in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that, Lord Jesus, in you we can prophesy. You say in your word right now, Lord Jesus, in the book of Ezekiel chapter 37, you stood and brought your servant Ezekiel over the dry bones. Tiko Namandlas, we are coming together as your church, as the peoples of the earth, my God, the earth that you created, my God, Tiko Namandlonge, and you founded it upon the waters and establish it and establish it upon the seas. Right now, oh Lord Jesus, we say we know that we are your idea. We have always been your idea from the beginning, oh Jesus, before the foundations of the world. You had established us, oh God, in your mind, oh Father. So we are coming before you in boldness. We are coming before you, Nkosiyam, with all confidence, knowing that we know that in you, Tiko Namandlonge, we can never be defeated. And right now we are joining in, oh Father, this morning with Ezekiel, that life will come forth over the dead bones, Lord Jesus, of our country, over the dead bones, Lord Jesus, of our health system, over the dead bones of those that are sick in the name of Jesus. We prophesy life, Father God. You say in your word, you ask Ezekiel to speak forth and put the breath that we have placed in him. Oh Lord Jesus, right now we place the breath that we have put in us, oh God, over the death situations in this coronavirus. Christu, we speak the breath of hope, we speak the breath of healing in the name of Jesus, we speak the breath of life. We hear the sound of the rattling of the bones, my God, coming together. We see the tendons, we see the flesh coming together, we see everything coming together. And yes, Lord, the army that has been slain, it is coming out and it is rising at this time and is walking up and down the streets, my God, of Port Elizabeth. It's walking up and down the streets of our province. It's walking up and down the streets of this nation, proclaiming your health, proclaiming your worth, proclaiming your life in the name of Jesus. Right now, Father, we thank you that the breath of life that is coming from the throne, that is oozing from the throne, is rising, Gosiam, within us, is rising within those, Lord Jesus, that are anxious at this time, is rising within those that are sick, is rising within, my God, those that are tired and discouraged. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. We bless your name as we start, Lord Jesus. We say, God, only you will be magnified in this place. In the name of Jesus, we bless you. We pray for the word, Gosiam, that is healing to our bones and strength, Gosiam, to our flesh. In the name of Jesus, we bless you and we praise your precious name. Amen. Hallelujah. If we were in church, I was going to say, come on, let's put our hands together as we welcome the Holy Spirit, as we acknowledge the Holy Spirit, as we acknowledge the Father, as we acknowledge the Lord Jesus Christ amongst us, as we enjoy the presence of heaven heaven amongst us, right there in your lounge, right there in your living room, right there in your bedroom, right there in your office. Bring your family together and let us praise the Lord together. Let us go to the word together. Let us dig into the word together and get the confidence and the life of God that is in his word. Be blessed and enjoy the rest of your day. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Woo.
Amen. Hallelujah. Wow, wow, wow. What a prayer. Praise the name of the Lord. I am sure that our faith is stirred up. We are ignited where we are, and we are ready to receive the word of the Lord this morning. And we want to again charge you and say, look, as a child of God, you have the grace to speak those things that are not as though they are. Amen. You have the grace and the right to change your situation. Speak into that atmosphere in your house, in your home. Amen. Speak to the atmosphere. Do not allow dejection. Do not allow fear. Do not allow any stress to dictate the atmosphere and the emotional state of your house and of your family and of your personal life in the name of Jesus. Prayer still works wonders even today in Jesus' name. Thank you so much, Pastor Trubi. The Lord bless you as we get to the word of God now. Come with me, Bazalwane, to the book of Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3. I'm going to be reading from verses 16, and I'm also going to read from verse 19, Daniel chapter 3. We will pick our text from here as we get on to the word of God. Daniel chapter 3, verse 16 says, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O King Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. If that be the case, our God that we serve is able, underline, our God that we serve is able. We serve a God who is able. He says, our God will deliver us from your hand, O King. Verse 18, he goes on to say, but if not, let it be known to you, O King, that we do not serve, we will not serve your gods, nor will we worship the golden image which you have set up. He says, but even if he does not save us, let it be known, O King, that we will not bow down, we will not worship the golden image which you have set up. And then verse 19, in fact, verse 28 says, Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel and delivered his servants who trusted in him. They have frustrated the king's word and yielded their robes, that they should not serve nor worship any god except their God. Verse 29. Therefore, I make a decree that any people, any nation, any language which speaks anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made as ash heap, because there is no other God who can deliver like this. Because there is no other God who can deliver like this. Praise the name of Jesus. The title of my message this morning is, there is no other God who can deliver like this. Akekho omnye uThixo onokuhlangula ngolu hlobo. Makabongwe uYesu. A brief recap of last Sunday's sermon. We made a declaration last Sunday wherein we were saying the Lord has told us that let us declare to the church and let us declare to the body of Christ in this season that it shall be well with the righteous, for the righteous shall eat the fruit of their labor. It is koseni ambono kuthi kumalungisa kuzawulunga kuwo ngokuba isiqhamo sezenzo zawo siza kudliwa ngabo. Tell the righteous, it shall be well with them. And this morning, I want to remind you of what God said last week to us, even this morning, that we shall enjoy the best of God in these worst of times. We shall enjoy the best of God in these worst of times. Let that declaration be forever on your lips. Let that confession be forever in your mouth. It doesn't matter what you hear. It doesn't matter what you read. It doesn't matter what you see. It doesn't matter what you hear happening next door. Child of God, continue to make this declaration that the best of God in the worst of times shall be enjoyed by me. I like what the Bible says, because it says in this book of Isaiah 3 verse 10, tell the righteous it shall be well with them. It says, for they shall eat the fruit of their labor. In other words, if you have labored in prayer, if you have labored in giving, if you have labored in service, if you have labored in whatever in your service in and your walk with God, God says, now it is the time for you to eat the fruit of your labor. Imigudu yakho, imithandazo yakho, imisebenzi yakho, isiqhamo sayo sizawudliwa nguwe. I remember, in fact, I recall the scripture we read last Sunday about in Genesis 26 about Isaac, who was commanded by the Lord in a time, in an era, in a season of famine and drought. When everyone else was running away, when everyone else was going down to Egypt, and even Isaac was considering, because of the prevailing status quo of the drought season, when everything was dying around them. Now God spoke to Isaac and said, do not go down to Egypt, but dwell in the land. Hlala apha kweli lizwe okulo. And God said to Isaac, plant in this land, cultivate in this land. In other words, God was saying to Isaac, look, labor in this land, sow seeds in this land, and get this one thing, that you are going to be blessed. You are going to see the best of me. I am going to bless you in this land. My brother, my sister, I want to say, even post this coronavirus, irrespective of what of the clear and present danger, clear and present reality that we shall be facing, I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, you will labor, you will work, you will innovate. God is going to give you divine strategy and ability to turn things around. In other words, God is saying, when he says, tell the righteous, it shall be well with them, and they shall eat the fruit of their labor. God is saying, you are going to resurrect dead things. As Pastor Shubi has just prayed now, you are going to speak to dead bones, dead situations, dead businesses. I see Christians, I see believers getting into dead situations, dead businesses, dead departments, things that are destined for doom. But when the children of God, who carry the grace of God, who carry the very life of God, Zoe, when they step into those situations, grace will be given them. They are going to resurrect dead things. My brother, my sister, you better get yourself ready, because I see children of God invited to serve in boards and companies like Joseph Joseph was invited in a time of famine, in a time of trouble in Egypt by the Pharaoh himself. He was taken from prison to the palace and he became the prime minister, the decision maker, the highest decision maker in the land. You know why? It was the grace of God that was upon him. And so he was able to labor and see great godly results. And so the Bible says, tell my righteous ones, it shall be well with them, and they shall eat the fruit of their labor. You are going to bring wisdom of God, the wisdom of God in affairs, even beyond your educational qualifications. Did you hear that? Child of God, beyond this time, because of the grace of God that is upon your life, you are going to be invited. You are going to sit in places because of the wisdom of God, because God's blessing is upon the children of God, upon the house of God, people of his kingdom. You are going to bring the wisdom of God even in affairs that are beyond your educational qualification. You will be a breath of hope in a hopeless world. That is what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, as he is saying to us, tell the righteous, it shall be well with them, and they shall eat the fruit of their labor. The best of God in the worst of times. You see, our God, brothers and sisters, our God, children of God, our God specializes in this. Our God specializes when hope is lost, when there is no answer, when people have come to that place of saying, curse God and die. God specializes in stepping in at the 11th hour, just when people were pronouncing doom, just when people were saying there is no answer. God is able to bring the best in the worst of times. God is able to turn things around for our good. In the name of Jesus. You know what? Last week, I saw something on the news, which I want to just read quickly to us now. I saw something there on the news, and I took a photo, a pic of this. It was saying, the title of this was A Difficult Truth. And this was the question that was asked. Can SA escape the worst of this epidemic? Is exponential spread avoidable? And the answer was no. Not unless SA has a special protective factor, in brackets, special mojo, not present anywhere else in the world. They said the only way that we can escape this epidemic, the worst spread and disaster and gloom, is only if SA could have a special protective factor or mojo not present anywhere in the world. I want to bring it to us this morning that yes, SA does have a special mojo. And this special mojo is present all over the globe. That special mojo is Jesus the Christ. It is God. It is Jehovah, the omnipotent God, the all-knowing God. He is the special mojo. If you are looking for a special mojo for this time, if you are looking for a special answer for this time, its name is Jehovah. And yes, it is there. Yes. SA can escape the worst of this. By the way, it will not be the first time we will be escaping. We escaped 1990, 1994, the worst epidemic, a civil war that was looming, that was clear over our country. Blood that was imminent and ready to be spilled all over. people armed and ready for battle. But God said no. The grace of God said no. Mercy said no. Jehovah said no. You know why? Because the church was praying. Because the believers were in prayer. Because the people of God in this country, they were looking up to Jehovah and saying, Lord, we have no one else to answer us. There is no one else to get us out of this ordeal. We are looking up to you, Jehovah. I want to declare this morning that Jehovah is the answer, that Jesus is the way. If you believe and I believe and we together pray to Jehovah, the answer will come. Jesus is that mojo that is going to see to it that 1,000 falls on our left, 10,000 on our right, but nothing comes near us. Jesus is that mojo that is going to make certain that healing comes over this our country. Hallelujah. Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. And Jesus is the life. If you call upon the name of Jesus, you shall be saved. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And you know what? The Bible is full of situations where God stepped in the worst of times and brought his best. I remember later on, after Isaac's time, and it was Jacob and Joseph's era, and the children of God went to Egypt, the Israelites. They were in Egypt, and whilst they were in Egypt, the Bible tells us, I don't have time to narrate the whole story, but they were in Egypt, the children of God, and they began to prosper even in Egypt, you see, because the prosperity and the grace of God does not matter where you are. You can be in a good situation, you will prosper. You can be in a bad situation, you will prosper. You will prosper at home, you will prosper in Babylon. When the hand of God is upon you, it doesn't matter where you are. The grace of God is not restricted by your geographical situation. The grace of God will make you prosper anywhere, anytime. Now, the Israelites were there, and the Egyptians began to be jealous about of them. And the Pharaoh that was in charge at the time decided that, you know what, let's persecute them, let's kill them, let's deal with these Israelites very harshly. And I like what the Bible says, Bazalwane, because the Bible says that the more they persecuted them, the more they multiplied. The more they persecuted them, the more they multiplied. In other words, the more they were afflicted, the more they were multiplied. They saw the best of God in the worst of times. I mean, nurses that were asked to kill the babies, the nurses from Egypt were the ones that ended up protecting the very babies they were tasked to kill. You know why? Because God is able to come through for us in the worst of times so that we see his best. Hallelujah. And in the interest of time, I want to just quickly bring my teaching to a close this morning by hitting on the text that I read earlier. This is another situation where the best of God was seen in the worst of times. Through these three guys by the name of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, these young men, they braved the fiery furnace when everything was said and done. Kusithwa kuvaliwe, kusithwa kuphelile, when everyone else was bowing to a golden image, in an era of compromise and gross idolatry, these three guys, Daniel's friends, they refused to bow, and they chose to bow to Jehovah. They chose, in the face of death, even though they could burn for it, even though they could be killed for it, but these men, in an era of imminent death and looming disaster, they decided to look up to Jehovah. They decided to honor God in the midst of a pandemic that was brought by the King Nebuchadnezzar of the time when he instructed a golden image to be erected in his name, his personal golden image, and he instructed everybody that bow to this image, worship this image. In other words, he made himself the God over that nation. And in that situation, there are three young men. When everyone else was scared, when everyone else was bowing, when everyone else was defeated, these young men decided to honor God. They decided to bow to God and refused to bow to no other. You see, even before I go on this one, laboring on this point, Bazalwane, I want to remind us where you are, that God honors those who honor him. That God looks after those who look to him. God stands with those who stand for him. God will say no to whatever comes against those who have said yes to him and who continue to say yes to him. Uthixo uyababonelela abambukayo. And so these young men, they are faced with a fiery furnace. They are faced with a test because they refuse to bow to the king. And God comes through for them, as we will later discover. But I want to take you back to Daniel chapter 1, verse 8, where the same young men, together with their friend Daniel, the Bible says, but Daniel, together with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they resolved, they decided that we are not going to bow to define ourselves like this. We are going to serve our Lord. And fast forward to chapter 3, the same people that refused to be defiled in chapter 1, when they had the opportunity to indulge of all the delicacies and all the foods that were sacrificed to the idols of Babylon. These men remembered that we cannot eat, we cannot defile ourselves with the foods that were sacrificed to idols, because we serve the great God Jehovah. Yes, they took a risk for that, but later on in chapter 3, we see God standing with those that had decided earlier to stand for God. And I want to bring it to us this morning once more, Bazalwane, and say the best of God is going to be enjoyed by those who had earlier decided to stand for God. When it was not popular to be a child of God, when it was not so famous amongst your friends, amongst your family to serve the Lord, and you said yes, when you could have bowed to drugs, when you could have bowed to alcohol, when you could have bowed to corruption, when you could have bowed to illicit sex, when you could have bowed to all the things of this world. But yes, my brother, yes, my sister, you chose to bow to Jehovah. He does not leave them on the way. He remembers their labor. He remembers the seed they have sown. He remembers what they have put into his kingdom. And when times of fire come, when times of floods come, when times of pandemic like these, God comes through for them. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they found themselves in a situation where they refused to bow and defied the king himself. The Bible says that the king was not so amused by this when he was told by his officials that these boys refused to bow to the image, even though he had a liking on them, but he decided, he was so angry with them, and he asked them himself, boys, I hear that you don't want to bow to this image, but I'm going to give you one more chance. When the sounds, the trumpet sound, I want you to bow and I want you to worship this golden image. And these boys, They responded. You see, because you've got to respond verbally to any attack that comes from the devil. You don't respond silently. You've got to verbalize. The Bible says you shall decree a thing and it shall be established for you. You've got to speak those things that are not as though they are. They were not silent. They did not respond to the king in their hearts. They spoke out loud. They said some of the most powerful words that you will ever hear said by a child of God in the scriptures. They said, "O king, we will not bow before you. Let it be known to you. We are not going to defend ourselves here, but our God will come through for us. We will not bow to you." And they even took it further. And they said that we know our God will save us. Uthixo wethu uzawusisindisa kule meko. But I like it because they go on to even say, "But even if he does not save us, we will not bow. Even if the worst were to happen to us, we will not bow." You see, I believe that these men in their spirit, they looked at Nebuchadnezzar. They saw, they knew his pedigree. They knew how notorious in his cruelty Nebuchadnezzar was. They knew that this guy could kill people and how he could kill them. But you know what? They also looked to Jehovah. And I'm sure that they had a revelation of what is said even in the New Testament, where Jesus says that you don't want to just fear the one who can kill, but you must also fear the one who cannot just kill, but who is also able to send into hell. And so they said, "We're not gonna fear a king who can kill the flesh, but we're gonna fear God who can also take to hell." And they say, "We would rather bow to Jehovah than bow to man." My brother, my sister, even in this season and even post-coronavirus, somebody has to make up their mind in this life as to who you're going to bow to. Are you going to bow to the things of this world? Are you going to bow to the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life? Are you going to bow to what is popular with man and not so popular with God? Or you will choose like the man Moses and say, "I would rather suffer affliction with the children of God than enjoy the pleasures of sin for a moment. I choose to bow to God. I will not bow to fear. I will not bow to panic. I will not bow to anxiety. I choose to bow to God. Death may be looming. Death may be imminent, but I choose to bow to Jehovah." They said, "O king, let it be known to you that we shall not bow to you." And the king was so angry at that. Fast forward the story. The king said, "Throw them in the furnace. If you boys want to dance with me, if you want to see what I'm capable of," he said, "bind them, bind their hands and bind their feet and throw them into the furnace, but not before you hit it 7 times. The king said, "I'm going to hit it 7 times. You see, sometimes we face troubles that are really multiplied. It's trouble left, right, and center, and you feel like it's like a furnace that is hit 7 times. There are people who are locked down, but you are locked down sick. You went into the lockdown with trouble already. You went into the lockdown with pain already. You went into the lockdown with a chronic illness already. It's like your hands are bound. It's like your feet are bound. You went into the lockdown with your business already, you know, smelling bankruptcy and liquidation. You know what? But you were thrown into, it's like you were thrown into the fiery furnace, bound hands, bound in your feet, and it is heated 7 times. But you know what? The God that we serve, he does not leave his people. He does not forsake them. The Bible says the man that threw them into the fire, the Bible says the heat was so much and the whole process was so hurried that the guys that threw them into the fire, they were burnt by the heat of the fire. Yet the people they were throwing into the fire survived in the fire. The other people were killed just by being around the furnace, not into the furnace. Hey, when Zanzalo Tiko Gwabake Abantu. Some people perish at the smell of trouble. Some people are destroyed just by being around pain. But you know what? The children of God, they go through stuff and they survive things. The Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him from them all. Hallelujah. We have a toala bakhe. We have a hole in Kelin. They took them. They threw them into the fire. The Bible says, after some time, the king started, stood up and started speaking into the situation and say, hang on. What's happening here? How many? He started asking. The king was looking at this intently. And he said, how many guys did we throw into the fire? They told him, three, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. But the king said, no man, it's not three guys there. I see four guys in this fire. And the king had a revelation that no man, the fourth guy looks like the son of man. That is Jesus Christ in the fire. You see, because God stands with those who stand up for him when they go through fires. When they were thrown in the fire, the consuming fire stepped into the fire with them and began to scorch the scorcher and began to burn the burner and began to neutralize the flames. Hallelujah. And that's what our God does in times of trouble, in times of sickness, in times of pain. We do have someone who is able to step with us into the trouble and trouble the troubler and destroy the destroyer and burn the burner and consume the flames. And instead of burning, they were praising the Lord in the fire. And the king was so shocked by this. He started calling them out of the fire. And he said, Shadrach, he said, Meshach, he said, Abednego, come out of the fire. Hallelujah. That's just like I'm saying to you even now. It doesn't matter what fire you are in. It doesn't matter what pain, what sickness. In the name of Jesus, I command you, come out of that fire. Come out of that sickness. Come out of that cancerous situation. In the name of Jesus, wherever you are, come out of that marital situation. Come out of that barrenness. Come out of that lukewarmness. In the name of Jesus, whatever fire you find yourself in this situation, I command you, in the name of Jesus, come out of that fire. You're coming out of that bitterness. You're coming out of that pain. You're coming out of that unforgiveness. In the name of Jesus, the king said, called upon them and said, come out of the fire. And they came out of the fire unharmed. But you know what, my brother, my sister, one thing that I love about that story is that the fourth man was with them in the fire didn't come out of the fire. He never came out of the fire. He remained in the fire. You know why? Because he is waiting, and he has always been, and he was waiting because he knows that somewhere in the future there are others who are going to be thrown into the fires of this life. And therefore, the Son of Man has always been waiting in the fire for us who will still get into the fire in the future. Zangipu malandota yesina mlilweni yahlala emlilweni ilinde wena namama ilinde wena nam daughter ilinde wena nam young man. That when you feel like you are alone in the fire, child of God, I want you to know that you are never alone. He is in the fire with us. In this pandemic, South Africa, we are not alone. We don't have to run elsewhere to look for help. Help is right here next to us. He does not leave them. He does not forsake them. He is with them in the fire. Jesus never left the fire. He stayed right there in the fire. waiting for you and me. I am so glad that even this morning, I am so glad that even today, whatever I will still experience in the future, even post-coronavirus, that Jesus is still with me, that He is with me in the fire. He is with us. Uhambanati, He is with us to scorch whatever that would want to scorch us, to drown whatever that would want to drown us. Hallelujah. And you know what? The amazing thing that happened was that he came out of the fire. This man, these three guys, they came out of the fire. And they came out, the Bible says, they were not even smelling fire. They were not even smelling the flames. You know what? When you've been around a braai, you will understand what I'm talking about. Even though you did not braai the meat, but just being around a place, a braai area, when you get home, your wife or your kids will say, "Daddy, where is the meat?" Not because they have seen the meat, but because they just smelled the smell, the aroma, the fragrance, the smoke in your clothes. But you know what? The Bible says this God, when He steps in to save us, when this man stepped out, there was not even a smell of flames. You see, Bazalwane, we are going to come out of this. We will not be smelling no death in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to declare that death, I will not even smell you in the name of Jesus. I speak to you away in the name of Jesus. We are coming out of this alive. We are coming out of this awake. We are coming out of this stronger than before. They came out of the fire. The chains fell in the fire. Hallelujah. And they came out with their garments still on. We are going to come out with our garment of praise still on. We're going to come out with our garment of prayer still on. And you know what? Those who were undermining what we were doing, those who did not understand our belief, and those who were ridiculing our faith, they will, like the king did, acknowledge our God. I like what he says here as I close this morning. The king, Nebuchadnezzar, said something. And he made a declaration after that. Remember, this is the same guy who had commanded everybody to bow to his image. Now he is so humbled by the Lord. He says he makes a proclamation. He makes a declaration and he says, "Therefore I decree that any people, any nation, any language which speaks against or amiss against the God of Shadrach, against the God of Meshach and Abednego, shall be cut into pieces. Their home shall be made as a heap of ash." And then in verse 30, and then he says, "Because there is no other God who can deliver like this." There is no other God. Because this man stood in faith, because this man believed they will see the best of God in the worst of times, because they decreed that our God will save us. They didn't say anything else, nothing else will save us. They said Jehovah will save us. They said only Jesus will save us. You see, and because God, you see, when you acknowledge God like that, heaven has no choice but to step in, because heaven is about to be glorified right there. The king said, "No other God is able to deliver like this." Utukumkani ndimbone ngowama mehlo uThixo wababantu. Bazalwane, let us believe. Bazalwane, let us stand in faith. Children of God, Church of Jesus Christ, this is no time for lukewarmness. This is no time to dilly-dally. This is no time to mix your reliance and your trust. This is time to put it up boldly and say, "In God I trust, in Jesus I believe." So that when we are delivered, when we are safe, when we are enjoying the best of God, people will testify on our behalf and say, "There is no other God like the God of these people." This is time for the church to enjoy and reap the benefits of trusting in God. So right there where you are this morning, you can call upon this God. You can trust in Jehovah. You can look to Him now. Uti Jehovah, save me. Jehovah, heal me. Whatever situation you find yourself in, you can call upon him. I declare once more, there is no other God who can deliver like Jehovah. I know him in my own life. And if you can trust in him, if you can call upon him even today, in whatever situation you're facing, if you can call upon him, he will save you. He will transform you. He will prove himself to you strong. And if that is you right where you are today, you need him to deliver you, you need him to save you, you need him to heal you, you need him to do whatever in your life today, just say, Jehovah, I look to you this morning. Say that prayer and say, Jehovah, I look to you today. Jehovah, I cry to you today in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you so much, Lord, for your grace, Daddy. Thank you so much, Lord, for your faithfulness. Thank you so much, Lord, for your total reliability, oh God. Thank you so much that we serve a God who is able to deliver. We serve a God who is able to deliver out of whatever situation. What is this pandemic? What is this coronavirus, my God? Because we have seen you deliver your children out of so many things. We have seen your best in the worst of times. And even now, Lord, we expect your best. We expect you to move, my God, like never before. We expect you, my God, to change the unchangeable. We expect you, Daddy, to fix that which cannot be fixed. We expect you, Daddy, to alter that which cannot be altered. My God, we come to you with joy. We come to you without hesitation. We are standing in faith and victory, for we know whom we serve and we know what you are able to do. There is no God who can deliver like this. We declare it in the name of Jesus that we shall be delivered out of this thing. We declare it, in fact, that we are delivered out of it already in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, I thank you that all those who call upon you, my God, you are ready to save them. All those who look to you, Jehovah, you are ready to receive them, my God. I pray that this nation, my God, will not be shy to look to Jehovah. My God, I pray that even our authorities will not be shy to say, in God we trust, in Jehovah we trust. That, my God, it will not just be moments of silence, but that, my God, it will be decreed aloud that, yes, there is no God who can deliver like this except Jehovah. Uthixo wamadinga. Siyakholwa Nkosi ukuba akakho omnye onokuhlangula ngolu hlobo. NguJehova, nguYehova, uThixo wamikhosi, nguYehova usonini nanini. Ithemba lethu likuwe. Our faith is in you. Our hope is in you. Simengawe, sibambelele kuwe Nkosi yamakhosi, even right now in Jesus' name. And we declare victory is ours. We declare joy unspeakable and full of glory. We declare the best of God in the worst of time. We declare that things are turning around to our good in Jesus' mighty name. We will declare it now. We will declare it tomorrow. We will declare it into the future until bonke abantu bavume, like the king acknowledged, that there is no God who can deliver like this. This is the word of God. I trust that you are blessed this morning, like I am. I trust that you are charged this morning, like I am. I trust that, Mzalanewam, today, yes, I trust that today you are inspired in your faith, just like I am. Yes, we shall eat the fruit of our labor. Praise the Lord. Of course, we cannot close as we close the meeting today without giving you an opportunity to once more labor before the Lord and sow seeds into the house of the Lord. Your tithe, hallelujah, bring it. We continue to bring it into the storehouse, hallelujah. We continue to bring our offerings into the storehouse. Everything that we had pledged, My God, to you, Jehovah, we are not going to be dissuaded. We will stay faithful even in the fire in the name of Jesus. And so I want to pray for you even as you give to the Lord. Remember that we are giving online now. Hallelujah. If you can, the bank account is flighted on the screens. That's where we drop our tithes, we drop our offerings for the storehouse and for all the needs of the house to be met. Hallelujah. And I can't wait for the RAG PE members. I can't wait for the day where I've got some very, very good news for us towards our whole building process and everything. I've got some very exciting news coming in there. And so I want to continue to encourage us and say, you know what? It doesn't matter what the devil may bring. He can bring his best. He can bring his worst. Our God will come true for us. And so we continue to sow. We continue to give. Hallelujah. I see a revival on the other side. Hallelujah. We may be delayed, but we will not be denied. Hallelujah. 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 We are going to see a revival. People are still going to stream into the house of the Lord. Do not even believe the lies that you will hear on TV where people saying that the church as we knew it, the time is over. People will never gather again. That's a lie from the pit of hell. My Bible tells me in Matthew 16, Jesus said, I will build my church. Hallelujah. And the gates of hell will not stand, will not prevail against it. And so we are looking forward to those times where we are still going to build more churches, where we are still going to reach out to more, we are still going to plant more congregations, and people are going to come to the temple of the Lord and worship the Lord and hear the truth of the Lord in the temple of the Lord. This is in the scriptures. We believe him for it. I'm receiving offering right now, but I'm really excited at what God is doing. So keep your commitments, Bazalwane. Keep sowing. Don't be dissuaded. Sow whatever you have blessed. Hallelujah. Don't look at the wind. Don't observe the waves like Peter did so that you sink. Keep your eyes on Jesus and keep the faith and keep giving. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us sow to the Lord. And as we're doing that, we also want to again encourage us. We will keep praying. We will pray until the end. We are going to pray. We are praying at 12 midnight. We are praying at 12 noon. Whichever hour that you can get, we want to join together. We want to pray that prayer of agreement. Even though we are separated, it's that hour where we can join together our faith and our prayers, praying for the nation, for the healing, declaring the grace of God, declaring the best of God over this nation, praying for our president, pray for the cabinet in the name of Jesus, praying for whatever decision makers we coming against corruptions and all those things and any other forces that would want to complicate the situation that we already find ourselves in. That kungangenelele ezinye izinto ezifuna uphazamisa umsebenzi omhle osowusenzeka in our nation. Let's pray for the doctors. Let's pray for the soldiers. Let's pray for the security forces. Let's pray for the police. Let's pray for any other essential service that is out there that has to be at work whilst we are locked down. Let's keep praying for them. You know what? I declare once more, there is a divine turnaround that is coming our way. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. Be blessed. Be blessed as you continue with the rest of your day and continue to glean on the word of God and continue to declare best of God in the worst of times in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you.